Jeff Schwartz at the COVID Free Cafe. Over to you guys.
To the COVID Free Cafe. That Dave Erb, he's got me so excited. Jeff, bam, right there. Look at that. 50, bam, on the barrel, right there. It's like the, no, this isn't a streamathon or a telethon. It's an herbathon. That's what this is. And I'm fired up. Jeff, so great to have you here. So many fantastic donations so far. And thank you for donating those face shields and the shirts.
Thank you.
Great stuff. So important, as we mentioned, in Ontario alone, over 500,000 people visit food banks each year. We're putting a dent in that.
You know what, James? I don't even know what to say. First of all, for folks that are at home, we breathe, and we breathe health and safety in this organization. We're actually 14 feet apart right now. You can't actually tell.
I can't hear you.
That's right.
Speak louder.
James, I'm over here.
What?
So, guys, on behalf of Dave and everyone in the organization, please donate. It is such an important time in our communities. It's a critical need right now to get food. Every dollar you donate provides three meals to an Ontarian in need. James put out, I think that looks like $20. It could be $30. It's nuts how many $5 bills. I am going to be donating right as I leave the chair tonight. $100 I'll be pledging towards the organization. And I'm getting a free visor from Dave. So, James, back over to you.
Beautiful. Now,
thank you.
Now, you know what? I think we're doing really well here. It was such a challenging year last year. That's why we have so many folks in food banks, unfortunately. As explained by the theme of this, of our awards, indomitable spirit. Though that's what we were really 2020 was all about. That now, given all the headwinds that the Enercare sales channel dealt with, I mean, they still did. Those numbers are fantastically amazing. So can you share your thoughts on how this happened in such a turbulent and difficult environment?
Yeah, no thanks, James. And look, you can only admire how amazing Enercare as a sales organization, as a field organization. We crushed it, folks. We crushed the sales this year. This is really truly one of our best sales years on record, and that's through CV19. Folks, you guys rose to the occasion. It's weird because, you know, what James mentioned before, Dave Erb really isn't wearing pants, so I hope the camera doesn't turn around. but James, let me ask you a quick question before I get into things. Mm-hmm. Ford versus Ferrari. Have you ever seen it?
Love that movie. Christian Bale and oh my gosh.
Hold on, I got it. Interesting story. So this goes way back. We've been planning this. It wasn't meant to be virtual, but we've been planning this for, you know, how long now, James?
A long time.
18 months,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah.
So well before COVID, James invited me to his house, and you guys saw the loft, and it's a very interesting story. So when we were at the loft together, James said, Jeff, do you want to watch Ford versus Ferrari? And I said, absolutely. It was incredible. So right behind us, remember when you guys saw on the camera, you saw that little den area in James's office, which is just behind that area. Literally, I think he said 16 by 24, Matt Damon, sign poster, huge, on the wall. I said, James, like, what's that all about? And James, what did you mention to me?
Well, I said that, you know, it's like, he wrote on it, and he said to James.
Yes.
The Canadian celebrity most like an Enercare hot water heater.
Oh my God.
Matt Damon.
Right.
Yeah.
So it's hard to make that stuff up. Listen, James goes way back with us. Look, if you think about Ford versus Ferrari, and you can get that image out of your mind, you know, at James's house and the whole picture, but we get serious for a second. The speed of the boss is the speed of the team. Do folks remember Lee Iacocca? Dave Erb, you remember Lee? He knows him. Good. One of the greatest business leaders of the 20th century. And what was so cool about it is he understood the importance of leading by example. First of all, Dave, this is interactive. Do you lead by example in this organization?
Yes.
You do. Scott Beneteau, if you're sitting with your family, Scott, do you lead by example?
Yeah.
Yes. Got it. June leads by example. Paula Doyle leads by example. Amy leads by example. Mackwich leads by example. I could keep naming names. This organization leads by example. Tom Mansfeld, you there?
Yes, I am.
He is there. Brian Blair, you home?
Woohoo!
Victoria Tan, Tracy Lee. This entire organization leads by example. 2020 was absolutely a tough year. We know that. It was grueling. We showed up every single day. We were one of the first in the market to don PPE. I remember we were sitting with Janine, and Janine said, we will spare no expense to ensure that we have full PPE for our front lines. And I remember we were sitting there as an organization. I think we were one of the first companies in Canada that were doing home services that had full PPE. We kept this business running, James. And James was saying when he was taking his bath earlier that this company is truly magnificent. Home services, commercial, builder, any division you're in, you set an incredible pace for this organization. And that's what leadership is all about, James.
That's right. Absolutely. And you know what? Amazing that you remember that poster.
Well, it's weird because sometimes when you go to someone's house, and I'm not always invited to comedians' houses, stars' houses, and you get a chance to wander around for a little bit and you see a poster of that size on the wall, James, it speaks to the person, the leader.
There you go. Very cool.
Yeah.
Now, Jeff, I understand. Obviously, you are a raving fan of people. I mean,
yes.
Your shout-outs are already your celebrity cameos. Just from this, I mean, I know how you keep track of it. It's crazy.
It's crazy.
But obviously, engagement to you is critical. Can you explain the drive that you have in this area and what it means to you and ultimately Enercare overall?
Thank you. Thank you, James. Well, I got to be very honest with everyone. There's nothing more important for those of you that know me than people. A very wise woman once said, I've learned that people will forget what you said. People will forget people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. Daryl, do you know who said that?
Maya Angelou,
exactly, Daryl. And that quote truly embodies how I look at the importance of people. It's the importance of putting our people first and foremost in everything we do. I spent 20 years or so in another organization before joining Enercare. And I can tell every single person on the screen today, without a doubt, this is not a company. We are a family. Each and every year, I spend time reading our engagement survey. I usually read it 2 or 3 times. And before I file it away, I can tell you, I have a feeling after reading the way people describe this organization. People describe over and over again, Enercare is a place where people support one another. It's an organization where people go the extra mile because they care about one another. Janine mentioned earlier how much we miss seeing people in the office, and we truly do. You walk into Birchmount office, you open the door, and you see 3 words on the wall when you come in from the parking lot. Exceptional, caring, and genuine. This is how we treat our customers, folks. This is how we treat each other. This is how we win together in the marketplace. And as you're sitting with your family and loved ones around the table, please know how thankful we all are for what they contributed to Enercare this past year. James?
Wow. Jeff, I mean, I'm telling you, man. You got me fired up.
I feel it.
I'm feeling the fire. Feel the heat. Now, the evolution, I mean, very challenging, especially, you know, with sales and marketing, because the approaches that we're taking now are so different than just a few years ago. Can you expand on that? And what else is changing in this whole world of COVID-19?
Yeah, James is so tied into the business, it's freaking me out. It's almost like he's done this sort of show before with us. And
right.
It's pretty beyond incredible. Look, you know, what's really exciting, you've seen a revamped marketing organization this year. And hello, Adrian, David, Karen, if you're at home, wave. But, you know, guys, folks have worked tirelessly across the organization, laser focus on objectives to develop key acquisition, retention, marketing programs that drive this organization to new heights. We know people go online to make decisions and to educate themselves before making that decision. So we need to focus on a couple areas with surgical precision, and the team has raised the bar. First and foremost, how many people right now on another screen are sitting on Enercare.ca scrolling through? Gosling,
I'm here,
you're on it. See, Dave, it's so crazy. So Dave and I are sitting in the green room. It's like a lot of people are sitting there. They're trying to talk. We're very far distant. Dave's been on Enercare.ca scrolling through for the last 2.5 hours. And that's one of the reasons why we have such tremendous results, because we have focus. We have people that are engaged in the content. In all seriousness, we're up 40% more web visits this year. So that's hard to do. And, you know, I know James is a big fan of Enercare.ca. He goes in all the time to look to add to the equipment that he has in our house. Our digital spend, and in COVID, we pivoted. We have some of our indoor air quality equipment working here today. The folks in Mississauga that are running the studio said, look, we want to have some indoor air quality. Who should we work at Enercare? I'll get to who they talk to a little bit later on. But the first and foremost is we have to make sacrifices as an organization this year. Folks will go back to April and May. It was hard, guys. We were all sitting around at home saying, when is this thing going to turn? We took some money out of the marketing budget, put it back into the organization to spend in other places. And I'm proud of the team because our web leads for 2020 were up 18%, budget for the full year down 3%. I mentioned IAQ. So what's really cool, Wahid is sitting there, and you guys saw his name in a bunch of slides earlier. Wahid sells more indoor air quality, so those UV bulbs. Wahid has sold more indoor air quality than any person in our organization. He sold more this year as an individual for the organization than the whole organization sold last year. He's been in my house to put it in. James has six of them in his house in his furnace that are, you know, sort of webbed together in an incredible system to keep his air clean. And in all seriousness, Wahid supplied indoor air quality for the building we're in today. So Wahid, we thank you. We've had some incredible plumbing executions, some electrical executions, and not electrocutions, I'm saying executions, Brian and the team at home. Incredible volume, and we saw some of the leads earlier. Honestly, folks, this team came together better than anything I've seen before. The difference is incredible, and all thanks to you. So thank you all so much.
James. Wow, and I guess I was wondering why this air quality it's amazing.
It is. It's incredible. I've never breathed this well before.
It's amazing. Yeah. You know, I feel it's great.
No, it's Wahid.
Yeah. Jeff, amazing talking to you.
Thank you.
Really appreciate the insights. And
thanks
for all the shout-outs to the folks at home. I know they were really appreciated. Now, I heard that you learned about the board-breaking indomitable spirit, and no prior experience.
None
whatsoever.
None.
Some instruction from the Urbanator, and you literally learn how to break with back kicks, which is no small feat. And then in the form of true indomitable spirit, not one, but you broke through two boards in one punch. Is that true?
No. It's partially true. Dave Erb had me here for an 11 and a half hour shift.
Okay.
We did a full training regimen. He pushed me beyond anything I've ever seen before. I'm still actually injured, but I'm, you know, happy to say that Dave has really been supportive through nursing through this injury.
Yeah, I bet you don't believe us, right, folks? Okay, Daryl, roll the clip.
I bet he could have done two boards. I know the guy. He got it in him for that.
Oh,